Sup guys, this is Ersafairi. Welcome to my channel, and if you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe so you will be updated for new videos. And today we're going to review this KP06 high kappa pistol from KJ Works, and I'm going to tell you my opinion about this particular gun. Okay, and as you can see, this is like a monster gun due to its size, because this is actually a 6 inches version of high kappa 5.1. okay, so for the comparison, this is how big is the KP06. okay, you will see it's really much bigger than the standard 5.1. okay, and this gun is in matte black finish with the accent of a silver, and it has a tactical look on it. Okay, you see. Okay, and I can say that this gun is pretty cheap for its price, because out of the box it's already pre-upgraded gun. Okay, and I'm going to show you which are the upgraded parts of this gun. And first, we just remove the magazine. Okay, now first we go to the sights. Front and the rear sight is fiber optic. Okay, it's a ready fiber optic sight, and not all the stock high kappa pistol we're going to have a fiber optic sight. Okay, and the rear sight is adjustable for windage and elevation. Okay, it's very nice touch. Okay, next is the slide. This slide is made of metal, and it's really looks solid, and it's heavy. Heavy slide. So because it's heavy slide, you can really feel the kick of this gun. Okay, this gun, it really kicks a lot. Okay, next is the lower frame. The lower frame is made of metal as well, and with a tactical rail underneath, so you can put your favorite tactical light. Okay, very nice. And this lower frame is a long dust cover. It means it's extend until to the end front part of the slide. Unlike the usual high kappa 5.1, the frame is only until here. Okay, but this one, it's all the way at the front. Next is the grip. Okay, the grip is made of high quality plastic. Okay, see, and with a kind of waffle design, textured. Okay, and if you hold this grip, you will feel that it's kind of big. Okay, because it's actually big, and it's, I believe, designed for big hands, and because this gun is also big, so it should have a big grip. So if you have a smaller hands, better if you just try it first and check if you're going to be comfortable holding this grip. But for me, it's very comfortable to hold this, and it's nice to the hands as well. Okay, and next is magwell. Okay, this is one of the pre-upgrades, because not all the high kappa pistol have already magwell on it. So okay, nice one, and it's really complementing with the color of the gun. Okay, see. Okay, next is the grip safety. Okay, it's made of metal as well, and this grip safety, if you didn't press down the grip safety, you cannot pull the trigger. Okay, you have to press it down so you can pull the trigger. Okay, so you just have to grip the pistol grip firmly, so at the same time you can press down the grip safety. Okay, next safety is the thumb safety. It is ambidextrous thumb safety, made of metal as well. And if this thumb safety, you can engage this thumb safety if your hammer is pulley down. Okay, then engage it. While it's engaging, even though you already pressed down the grip safety, still you cannot pull the trigger. Okay, so to pull the trigger, you have to disengage the thumb safety. Okay, see? And another safety feature of this gun is the half cock safety. Okay, what it means is when you rock the slide and you don't want to fire it, just put the hammer to half cock position. Okay, just like that. And even though you're already pressing down the grip safety and your thumb safety is disengaged, still you cannot pull the trigger. Okay, to pull the trigger, you don't have to rock the slide, just pull the hammer all the way down, then that's it. So there are several safety features about this gun, so it's very nice. Another one is another enhancement for some high kappa pistol is the extended slide lock release. Okay, because it's extended, when you're holding the pistol, you don't have to change the position of your hands, because when it's the when you want to release the slide, the extended slide lock release is very reachable. Okay, like that. So you don't have to change the position of your hands. So this is very nice touch on this pistol. Okay, and another one. Okay, by the way, the mag release is made of metal also. Okay, and another pre-upgrades that's very nice in this gun is the trigger. Okay, you can see you have a very nice aluminum trigger. Okay, and the trigger is already adjustable. Okay, not all stock pistol came with adjustable trigger. See, it's very nice. Okay, and now let's check about internals. Internals, okay, the guide rod. Okay, guide rod is made of metal, and I'm not sure what kind of metal it is. I'm not sure if stainless or made of steel. Oh, okay, I just checked it just now. Okay, it's made of steel. So it's good, it means it's durable. Okay, so it's made of steel. Okay. Okay, and you have here a very strong recoil spring. Okay, this strong recoil spring will help the heavy slide to cycle smoothly and give you a very hard kick as well. Okay, so it's very good. And this is your hop-up. It's just a typical hop-up unit. Okay. And this is your hop-up wheel to adjust your hop-up. Okay. And another good upgrade for this gun is the red loading nozzle. Okay. Usually, when other airsofter upgrading their airsoft pistol, they actually buy this loading nozzle from KJ Works, because this loading nozzle can handle the CO2 gas. So it means that this is very durable enough. Okay, so nice. And the lower, okay. By the way, this pistol, it's already been in the market for so long already, maybe 10 years more or less. And I already watched almost all the review and video for this pistol, because before I get this one, I actually watched all the reviews, something like that. And none of them mentioned that the hammer assembly of this gun is actually made of steel. Okay, it's actually made of steel. I don't know if they just forget to mention it or they're not aware of it. Okay, the disconnector, the bulb knocker reset, the bulb knocker itself, and the sear is made of steel. So this is really a very good upgrade for this gun. Okay, and if you're going to buy this steel parts, it will cost really more for the upgrades. So, and this is very good because it's already in this gun. So okay, and now we're going to test fire it. Okay, and we're going to use this CO 0.20 BBs. Okay, that's enough. I don't have gas, and I'm using this gas because I don't have the green gas, so I'm using this map gas. Anyway, since this gun can handle CO2, I think this gas is safe to use for this gun. But the problem with this gas, this is a dry gas, and this has no silicone on it, so it will harm your O-rings. Okay, it will harm your O-rings. So when using this kind of gas, you should always maintain your O-rings. Okay, and this gas is not not for all high kappa pistol. Okay, this is not for all high kappa pistol, because this gas is quite they said it's, the pressure is much higher than the green gas. I'm not sure. Okay, so just check your always maintain your pistol. Okay, now let's put some. Okay, okay, that's it, and let's check it out. It's 402. It's actually high pressure. Yes. 389. Okay, it's going down. Okay. Anyway, it's going down. 383. Okay, 381. 361. D7, D59, D36, oh. 300. Oh, we ran out of gas. So it didn't lock. We still have BBs. So it's just that we just ran out of gas. See, no more. But it's okay. At least you have an idea how it shoots. And this pistol is actually 100% stock. Okay, I didn't change anything on this pistol. What I do is I just enhance the air seal. That's it. But it's all 100% stock. Okay. So, what can I say? It's my opinion. It's only my opinion. I can highly recommend this one for, especially for the beginners. Okay, because first, it's cheap. It's only about 6,800 pesos, and it's cheap because of the pre-upgrade parts within this pistol. So I can say it's really cheap for its price. Okay, because usually you have to buy this fiber optic sight, this adjustable trigger, and some are like the extended slide lock release. And usually this standard lock slide lock release really don't come with the other high kappa pistol. Yeah, and the loading nozzle, okay, and especially the steel hammer internals of this pistol is, if you buy that one, it costs a lot. Okay, so it's really a good upgrade. So if you're going want to upgrade this one more, I think for me, I'm just going to change the inner barrel and the hop up chamber and the hop up wheel, backing. That's it, because for the looks, external looks, for me, I don't have to change anything. Okay, because this looks badass already. It looks beautiful. It looks solid, and it's actually solid. Okay, so less headache, because if this one is functioning properly, maybe you just try to tune it up so it will not shoot very high differences, but this one is really good. Yeah, so I highly recommend for the beginners. Okay, and if you want to feel the kick of it, this one is the best. Okay, and especially if you're going to use a CO2, this will kick a lot. So this gun is, for me, is winner. Okay, highly recommended for beginners out there, and also to not beginners like others. Okay, because you're just going to upgrade just a few things, only basic, only the inner barrel and the hop up unit. That's it, and nothing more, nothing less. So it's a good gun. Okay, that's it. So I hope you enjoy this video and you have an idea for this kind of pistol. It's KJ Works KP06, very cheap gun. Okay, and that's it. And don't forget to like, shares, and subscribe. So if you didn't like this video, thank you anyway for watching it. Okay, and this is Airsoft Fairy. Thank you.